Myself Rajalakshmi Asidai from Vidyalakshmi First Year College, Savannur. Now I am taking Financial Accounting 5th sem under that chapter Redemption of Preference Shares. So this is the problem appeared for the year 2013 and 16. So you can refer the problem given in the question bank. It is for 2013 and 16. Once again, shortly I return the problem here. See, here is the liability side, this is the asset side, this is the adjustment given in the problem. First, we have to see how much shares to be redeemed. Here, the shares redeemed is, redeemable preference shares is 65,000. And whether there is a premium, so read the problem. Redeem the preference shares at 10% premium. So at 10% premium, we have to redeem the shares. Then, next one is, how to redeem the shares? Before redeeming the shares, we have to see how the shares were redeemed. It is given, sell the investment for rupees 16,000. For redeem the shares, we have to sell what? Investment for rupees 16,000. See the balance sheet. Here investment is given 18,500. So the first journal entry will be, I am just writing the journal entry and the amount. So first journal entry, for selling the investment. When you sell the investment, cash comes in. Don't buy it. So just think about the entries. So when you sell the investment, bank comes in. So how much amount it is comes in? 16,000. And what goes out when you sell investment? Investment goes out. So credit what goes out? So investment account should be credited. So what is investment amount goes out from the business? It is 18,500. Rules is debit should be equal to credit. So here credit is 18,500. Debit is 16,000. So this 2,500 difference. So 18,500 investment, we are sold for lesser amount, 16,000. That means this amount is the loss. Loss on sale of investment. It should be transferred to profit and loss account. Understood? So it is 16,000 we are realized from the investment. Actual value is 18,500. That loss should be transferred to profit and loss account. This is the first journal entry. Then, next. Whether, we have to see whether there is a fresh issue of shares or debentures. So in second adjustment it is given, leave a balance of rupees 12,000 in profit and loss account. So that means we have to leave 12,000 in profit and loss account and use the other profit and loss account balance to redeem the preference shares. So leave a balance of rupees 12,000 means this 12,000 should be shown in the balance sheet. So it should be kept in the balance sheet. So it should be shown in the current year balance sheet. Idu leave ishtu 100,000 bittu ulida balance the profit and loss account tagolli anta adra meaning. Leaving 12,000 should be kept in the business under profit and loss account and other balance, that means here it is 48,000. Out of that we have to keep 12,000 and the remaining should be used for the redemption of preference shares. So we have to keep 12,000. Then it is next, see the next adjustment. To issue sufficient number of shares. It is not given in the problem how much fresh issues we have to make. So we have to make how much shares. It is given sufficient number of shares means if any balance is not available for the redemption of preference shares after using this profit and loss account, if anything is needed for the redemption of preference shares, then we have to use the issue of equity shares. So equity shares of rupees 50 each, see here the face value itself is rupees 50 for equity shares. So 100 is irbekuntilla illi kottidare 50 each means face value of the share is 50 rupees at a premium of rupees 30 per share. So equity share should be issued at a premium of rupees 13 per share. So in this case, first we have to find out how much equity shares we have to issue to the public. Then how to calculate it? So calculation of issue of equity shares. See here, how much we have to redeem the preference shares? So redeemable preference shares amount is 65,000. How much we can utilize from this profit and loss account? So less from profit and loss account. See here carefully. We are having here 48,000. Out of that 48,000, see the first journal entry. The loss is 2,500. So it is the journal entry number 1. So we suffered a loss of 2,500 from the sale of investment. So it should be deducted. At the same time, it is given 12,000 should be kept in the profit and loss account itself. So minus 12,000. So we have 48,000. Out of that, 2,500 is the loss on the sale of investment. Then we have to keep, it is given in the problem, we have to keep or leave rupees 12,000 in the profit and loss account. So that much of amount should be taken from the profit and loss account. This is total 33,500. So 48,000 minus 2,500 minus 12,000. So this is 33,500. So the remaining balance we get is, it is 31,500. So it should be paid through equity shares. So equity shares is less to that way, answer is answer. So we have to redeem 65,000. Out of that, in profit and loss account, we have 33,500. After leaving 12,500 and after deducting the loss, then we are having 31,500. So for this, we have to pass the second entry for the issue of equity share. So the journal entry is same. What is the journal entry for the issue of fresh issue of equity shares? Then we issue the shares, bank comes in. So bank account data to equity share capital account. How much capital is it? Is 31,500. See whether there is a premium. Yes, it is given. Each at a premium of rupees 13 per share. So we have to pay rupees 13 per share. So how to find out the number of shares? See, the amount is 31,500 divided by face value of the share is 50 rupees. Face value of the share is 50 rupees means we get 630 equity shares. So we have to find out number of shares because here it is given premium is rupees 13 per share. So how to find out the number of equity shares? So here it is the share capital 31,500. So the face value is 50 rupees. So it is the face value of the shares. So we have to issue 630 equity shares. So now it is easy. So two entries, securities premium account. How much share it is? 630 shares into premium is rupees 13. Premium is rupees 13. We get 6,290. 6,290. So the total is 39,690. So this is the problem. 39,690. Understood? So equity share capital is 31,500. So 13 rupees premium. So 630 into 13, so it is 6,290. So the total bank account is 39,690. Next, the entry is for the difference of premium. See here once again, we have the security premium of rupees 6,290. 90. We have the premium of rupees 6290. So next entry for redemption of preference, the premium. So it should be paid out of securities premium, because securities premium is given. So the entry is, it should be paid through security premium. Security premium account debtor are to premium on redemption of preference shares account. Securities premium account debtor are to premium on redemption of preference shares account. Preference shares account. So it is security premium is given 6290. So how much premium you have to pay for the redemption of preference shares? 65,000. So premium is payable at 10%. So it is 6,500. So it is. Sorry, here it is 8,190. That is, sorry, the amount is changed. Just mistaken. It is 630 rupees into 30 means it is 8,190. Sorry, it is because of eye problem. So the amount is 8,190. So we have 8,190 in security premium account, but we have to redeem the premium of redemption preference shares is only 6,500. So we can use it. So the entry is security premium account debtor to premium on redemption of preference shares account. It is 6,500. So the next entry is over. Next entry is difference between the capital. Difference between the capital. So it should be taken by the profit and loss account. So the entry is profit and loss account debtor to capital redemption reserve account. It is the difference between capital. So this capital is 65,000. See the entry number 2. So fresh issue is how much it is? Fresh issue is 31,500. Deduct this 31,500. So it is 33,500. So 33,500. So profit and loss account debtor to capital redemption reserve is 33,500. Once again, that means difference between the preference shares and fresh issue of equity shares. So 65,000. This is 31,500 is journal entry number 2. Refer journal entry number 2. So this is relating to the capital difference. Next entry is as usual. We have to transfer the capital and premium to shareholders. So the entry is redeemable preference shareholders. Sorry. Preference share capital account debtor, redeemable preference share capital account debtor, it is 65,000. Next, premium on redemption of preference shares account debtor, see the last journal entry, it is 6,500, that is 10% of premium. Two, it should be paid to the shareholders. So, redeemable preference share holders account. This should be paid to the redeemable preference share holders. So, the amount is 71,500. We have to pay 71,500. Understood? Redeemable preference share capital and premium on redemption of preference shares. It should be transferred to redeemable preference share holders account. So, the last entry, we have to pay the amount to the redeemable preference shareholders. So the entry is redeemable preference shareholders account debtor. Then you pay the amount, cash goes out once again. So to that account, same amount here. Redeemable preference shareholders account 71,500. To bank account 71,500. So this is relating to the journal entry. Come to the revised balance sheet. Be careful about the balance sheet. So first I will write here the asset side. So fixed asset will be remaining same. Same, no changes. 3,45,000. Then don't take investment because it is sold. Then it is bank account. So bank account, how much amount is there? Here we have 31,000. See the journal entry, first one. Bank account debit. Asset is shows always debit balance. If the debit balance is means add in bank account, once again debit bank means add in journal entry. Credit means less. So first journal entry bank account data. So it should be added. 16,000 should be added. Next second one also. It is 39,690 should be debited. So it should be added. 39,690. Then we have to deduct what? Last, see the last journal entry. It is paid to the debenture holder 71,500. Once again, see the opening balance is 31,000. So it is 16,000 first journal entry we have to add. Then 39,690 is the second journal entry. Then we have to deduct the last. So it is in credit. We have to deduct 71,500. Then we get the bank balance. Here it is 15,190. We get 15,190 in bank account. Then come to the liability side here. Liability side. Just now you can see only liability side here. It is important. Redeemable preference shares means it is over. Then next is equity shares. Equity shares. So 4,500 equity shares is there. 4,500 equity shares. Plus, see the fresh issue. How much equity shares? We issued 630 issue of shares. See the fresh issue of shares. Number of shares is 630. So total we have 5,130 equity shares of rupees. The face value is, it is important, 50 rupees. Of rupees 50, we will get 2,56,500. 2,56,500. Then, after capital, we have to write the reserve. It is important. Here it is capital redemption reserve. See the journal entry, fourth profit and loss account data to capital redemption reserve. It is 33,500. Next comes to P&L account. It is given left how much? 12,000. It is given in the problem left 12,000. If you are having any doubt, you can once again see the opening balance is 48,000. So the profit and loss account is a liability. So credit item should be added, debit should be deducted. So first entry debit, so minus 2,500. See the second entry, no. Third, no. See the fourth journal entry, minus 33,500. So I think it surely comes to 12,000. Yeah, 33,500. That means 14,000, 15,000, 16,000 minus means 11,000. Yes, correct. So profit and loss account, or you can write here it is leave. Leave 12,000 means we have to show the 12,000 in balance sheet. So counter check is we have 48,000 less 2,500 general entry less the fourth general entry 33,000. 500, we get 12,000. Then write creditors as it is. So creditors is 56,500. If you see the asset side and liability side, it will tally the amount of this is, sorry, one is remainder. That is, we have securities premium this much, 8100. So write securities premium within bracket. So we have 8190 minus, see the journal entry number 3, for the redemption we are using only 6500. It is important, ಇದನ್ನ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ 8190 ಶೇರ್ಸ್, ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ 6500 ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರಿಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಗೆಟ್ 1690. ಸೊ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೋತ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಈಸ್ 3 lakh, ರೈಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಬೋತ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಯಾಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ 3,60,180. So the total of the balance sheet is 3,60,180. So very easiest chapter this one is redemption of preference shares. With this, we can end this problem over 10.